Thank you so much for being online in pursuit of being a learner. सबसे बड़ी खूबी यह है कि आपको और मुझे ये जिंदगी सीखने का एक मौका देती है. It's a great opportunity to learn every day and get better every day. Whatever the circumstance, whatever the problem the world has, you and I still cannot be bound. At least what we have between our ears. It cannot be contained by anything in this world. There are people who have stayed inside the jails and still expressed, still lived. Jail ke andar band hote hue bhi, insan ki soch ko, insan ki akhal ko, kisi jail mein aaj tak band karne ki koshish nakam rahi hai. So what am I trying to do? What am I interacting with you? Maine bahut socha, students zyada honge इस ऑडियंस के अंदर, तो मैं क्या उनके साथ बात करूं, बोल के अक्सर मैं जब स्टेज पे होता हूं, आप लोगों के साथ होता हूं, तो यू नो द काइंड ऑफ एनर्जी एंड द काइंड ऑफ एक्टिविटीज वी डू. लेकिन ऑनलाइन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ एक्टिविटीज आई कैन डू विद यू? आई विल कम आउट विद सम एक्टिविटीज, यस, लेटर ऑन. बट टुडे आई थॉट आई विल सेट अ स्टेज फॉर यू एंड आई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द कैपेसिटी, व्हाट इज द केपेबिलिटी यू एंड आई एज ह्यूमन बीइंग्स हैव. एंड दैट आई थॉट I should narrate to you through a couple of stories. The first story I'm going to tell you is about my own experience in traveling to the African country, Nigeria. Why I'm sharing this is because most of the times when we are in our comfort, in the place where we stay, and we have this unique understanding of things around us, तो हम लोग समझ नहीं पाते कि हमारे पास एक्चुअली क्या चीज, क्या नियामतें हैं. व्हाट आर द थिंग्स विच वी हैव विच आर सो यू नो वी आर सो ब्लेस्ड विथ, राइट? समटाइम्स यू नीड टू ट्रैवल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट. दैट्स वन ऑफ द रीजंस व्हाई यू एंड आई हैव टू हैव ट्रैवलिंग एज वन ऑफ द गोल्स इन लाइफ, राइट? राइट नाउ द एंटायर वर्ल्ड इन कॉमन इज सीइंग अ वेरी यूनिक फीचर वेयर यू एंड आई आर नॉट अलाउड टू मूव आउट, राइट? Times when we had an opportunity to travel, we have not made use of that opportunity. So one of the most important things which I am sharing with you right now is when this lockdown or this COVID ka jo pandemic end hota hai, please spend good amount of your income, revenues, savings on traveling out and seeing the world. Traveling doesn't mean going to a resort. Traveling doesn't mean going and staying put in some place of pleasure. Traveling means just going out and exploring the world, the beauty of the world. The kind of offering, the kind of learnings you get are just immense. So this is one of the things which I want to highlight. Secondly, as I said, my visit to Nigeria in 1999, right? So when I landed there, I saw a completely different world. In 1999, in Nigeria, I was shocked to see things which you and I will not be able to understand and comprehend. So, the moment we landed, we had a set of instructions. जैसे ही वहाँ पे land हुए, वहाँ पे instructions दिए गए airport के अंदर, जहाँ पे लोग who came to pick us up, they said, see here, you will have to change your way of being. You should not be the same way you are in your own country. You have to change. Now, what are the changes? If somebody on the road, stops you, do not stop. If somebody stops your car, do not stop. Just move. Never pull down your windscreen or the glasses of your car. Never pull it down. Never put your car in crowded places. And if somebody, in case you have to visit the market, if you visit the market, in some cases, people come and ask money, do not refuse, give them some money. And these kind of instructions, every single cloth you're going to wear has to be ironed, hot, steam ironed, and things like that. And it was a completely different world. When I went there, I lived there for a month, I realized how blessed we are to experience the freedom we have wherever we live today. In spite of all the difficulties, still you and I have amazing, freedom to actually do what we want to do. But we don't realize that, right? I had a very strange experience in Nigeria in the market where One of the beggars walked up to me. Yeah, this is just an example I'm giving you. One of the beggars walked up to me and said, "Give me the money." He didn't ask. He's demanding, "Give me the money." And he's putting his hand into the car. I mean, the windscreen, as you know, they had instructed me to keep it up, the glasses of the car up. Thodi gap thi, wo gap mein se haath dal ke, he's trying to reach out to my purse and grab the purse. And then we had to give him some money and say, and he's threatening, "If you don't give me the money, I will spit on your face." We never experienced that, right? Every single cloth you wear, including your undergarments, has to be steam ironed. It has to be ironed because there are insects which are so dangerous. They lay eggs in the cloths, in your clothes, and that can be dangerous for you. Fatally dangerous. I mean, it can be बहुत severe disease हो सकते हैं. तो वहां पे ये आम हालात हैं. हम ऐसे खास हालात जैसे हम लोग एक्सपीरियंस कर रहे हैं इसकी बात नहीं बोल रहा हूं. इट इज अ डेली नॉर्म दैट दीज पीपल फेस. व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू हाईलाइट टू यू, यू एंड आई हैव द चॉइस दैट इन अंडर एनी सर्कमस्टेंस. एंड व्हेन आई सॉ देयर इन नाइजीरिया, पीपल आर लीडिंग नॉर्मल लाइव्स. देयर आर मेनी यू नो थाउजेंड्स ऑफ इंडियंस हु आर लिविंग देयर इन नाइजीरिया हु आर कंप्लीटली नॉर्मल. द इंसिडेंट्स ऑफ यू नो किडनैपिंग आर वेरी हाई. The incidents of you know barging into your house and raiding your house, robbery, daylight robbery, very common. I don't know the situation right now, but this is my experience in 1999, right? So what am I trying to tell you, that कोई भी हालात के अंदर इंसान को अपनी जिंदगी normally जीने की कोशिश करना चाहिए, because this world is definitely a test for you and me. And what matters is how strongly we are able to manage our emotions in this. And that managing the emotions, you and I have a choice. Haan, agar hum chahe, to we can give all the excuses for not being happy. And if we want, we can give all the excuses for being happy and all the reasons for being happy. So moving forward, I would like to give you another example, another story of my visit to Thailand. And this is a story which probably can give you a spirit of how you and I need to actually lead our lives. हमारी जिंदगी, हाँ आप student हैं, लेकिन इससे हम सीख सकते हैं कि हमारी और आपकी जिंदगी क्या होनी चाहिए. And this is a very comprehensive story. And this is a story I can never forget. हाँ, इसमें bits and pieces I have forgotten. And this is a story of, coincidentally, ये 1998 की कहानी है. When I had gone for a project to Thailand, Bangkok में एक project था हमारा, and it was a very huge project of an Asian Games complex, और हमें वो project award किया गया था. और ये चीज मैं story के हिसाब से कैसे बता रहा हूँ आपको, क्यों? क्योंकि इंसान को कहानियां, stories, narration, shared stories, incidents, इसकी बहुत ज्यादा value होती है. और जब कोई shared incident, shared story, incident बताया जाता है, उसकी जो मेमोरी के अंदर लॉन्गेविटी है, उसकी मेमोरी के अंदर जो इट कॉन्क्रीट्स इन टू द मेमोरी एंड यू रिमेंबर इट फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम. दैट्स द रीजन आई थॉट टूडे आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू गो इन द मोटिवेशनल डायरेक्शन, आई एम गोइंग टू गो इन द स्टोरी डायरेक्शन, एंड आई एम ट्राइंग टू गिव यू मोर एंड मोर इंसिडेंट्स विच कैन रियली मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू एंड आई हैव अ रियल चॉइस ऑफ एक्चुअली लिविंग दिस लाइफ, नॉट सर्वाइविंग. मोस्ट ऑफ द ह्यूमन बींग्स क्या करते हैं, सर्वाइव करते हैं. लेकिन आपको और मुझे जो है ये जिंदगी दी गई है जिंदा रहने के लिए. मैं अक्सर बोलता हूं, जिंदगी जिंदा दिली का नाम है, मुर्दा दिल क्या खाक जिया करते हैं. हालत कैसे भी हो, आपको चॉइस है दैट यू वॉन्ट टू एग्जिबिट एंड लिव योर लाइफ टू द फुलेस्ट. एंड दैट इज माई मैसेज टूडे, लिव योर लाइफ टू द फुलेस्ट. डोंट कॉम्प्रोमाइज, डोंट वेट. It's not, I mean, pandemic ending and this whole thing, lockdown opening and all that may happen. We don't know when. But why are you compromising it today? Aaj aapki zindagi aapke haath mein hai. God has given it to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ne ye zindagi di hai aapko niamat ke taur pe, gift ke taur pe, and you need to live that, right? So I landed in Bangkok in 1998, and I was told that we will be working with a gentleman from Japan. तो मैं बहुत एक्साइटेड हो गया, बिकॉज यू नो व्हाट, जापानीज के साथ एक खासियत होती है, जापानीज, एक जापानीज, मेरा मानना है, ये मेरा मानना है, दिस इज माय ओन थिंकिंग, इट्स नॉट दैट इट्स अ रूल, दैट माय थिंकिंग इज दैट वन जापानीज इज इक्वल टू वन यूनिवर्सिटी, दिस इज माय थिंकिंग, राइट. सो आई वाज वेरी एक्साइटेड, यार जापानीज से मिल रहा हूं एंड इससे कुछ सीखने को मिलेगा मुझे, ही इज लाइक अ यूनिवर्सिटी, मैं उसके साथ थोड़े दिन गुजारूंगा, सो आई वुड बी एबल टू मेक अ लॉट ऑफ, आई वुड बी एबल टू गेन अ लॉट ऑफ नॉलेज, लॉट ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग, लॉट ऑफ विजडम फ्रॉम हिम. सो आई लैंडेड, आई वॉज वेरी एक्साइटेड. And when you go to meet somebody for the first time, you have a perception in your head, right? This person is going to be like this. This person is going to be like this. So in my head, there was a perception. There's going to be a young, dynamic Japanese engineer going to come and meet me. And, you know, young guy. And we're going to have a lot of interaction, a lot of fun. So that was the perception I had. I landed and I was searching in the airport. You know, when you get out, you have all these people holding placards and waiting for you. And as I was looking, there was a man holding a placard and waiting. And he was a very old man. He was holding my name placard and waiting. And I went to him. I said, that's me. And I'm still assuming that he, this old man, is the driver of the person I'm going to meet. So, मैं सोच रहा था ये ड्राइवर है, ये मुझे लेने आया है एयरपोर्ट से, तो मैं इसके साथ जाऊंगा और उसके मालिक और उसके बॉस को मिलूंगा. सो दिस इज, आई मीन, व्हेन यू गो टू थाईलैंड एंड चाइना, यू कैन नॉट मेक आउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन पीपल, राइट, देयर फेसेस आर ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द सेम. सो आई वाज अंडर दैट इंप्रेशन. आई सेड ओके, ड्राइवर आया है मुझे लेने के लिए. सो एज वी स्टार्टेड वॉकिंग, आई शुक हैंड्स विद हिम. इंसान को इंसान के साथ कभी भी ग्रीट करके, यू हैव टू ग्रीट पीपल, राइट. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स यू एंड आई फॉरगेट ग्रीटिंग people just because we think that they are not very important. ये ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए, इंसान के अंदर ये फितरत नहीं होनी चाहिए. We always have to greet people who are, you know, even a lift operator or a security guard is a human being. The maid who works in your house is a human being, right? The person who drives for you is a human being. You have to greet, you have to talk to them with respect. That reflects who you are. It's not about who they are, it's about who you and I are. If I'm able to talk, so that is a habit I have developed, because it really helps. I've learned from my elders, it really helps in respecting people the way any human being has to be respected. And we cannot differentiate. Just because a leader or a politician comes, we stand up and try to give him extra respect, whereas it's a person who's working for us, or a driver or a security guard, we respect him less? No. That's not the right way. So, my dear friends, youngsters especially, हम लोगों के अंदर ये values ना हो तो आप और मैं इंसान नहीं रहेंगे. We are not going to be human beings. We are lesser than animals if we do that. So, my humble request, one of the things take away for this session is notice people around you who are making your lives comfortable and easy. Genuinely from your heart, give them their respect. Consider something for them, some time for them. If you're walking, it's your driver or your, you know, the person who takes care of your house, the gardener, the cook, or the person who takes care of the vessels in your house, the washing of the clothes, or the lift operator. In logon ke liye thoda bahut waqt dein, right? The vegetable vendor. Just talk to them. 2 minutes. 2 minutes is not going to take away anything from you, but your 2 minutes can make an immense difference for them. So, this gentleman who picked me up from the airport as we were walking and we were going out, and I shook his hand and said, my name is Habib, and he shakes his hand, he said, my name is Pichai. And that's the exact name given to me, that's the man I'm going to work with. So, I was like quite shocked. I thought he's the driver, but look at it, he is the man, and he's very old. And we start talking, and he didn't have a driver. He had a very expensive car, Mercedes-Benz, and a high class, I mean, the latest Mercedes-Benz at that time. And I went along with him, and he opened the door for me. I sat down. He came. He was driving his own car, and he was pretty, of course, when we went for a long trip, he had his own driver. But then he just came to pick me directly from the airport. He didn't send his driver to pick me up. So look at the way a person deals with you. And then I was looking at him and he's old, and somewhere, you know, I was losing my heart saying that I would have had an opportunity to work with a young and dynamic engineer anyway. It's an old man. I can't demand much from him. So I was feeling a bit compromised in my heart. And I said, anyway, let's move and see what's there. But I started noticing something very unique about this man. A lot of laughter, a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of, you know, happiness, a lot of jokes, and he was like so vibrant. And as we started developing a good rapport, he dropped me off at the hotel and, you know, he picked me up next morning. He said, I'll come and pick you up at 7 o'clock. So I usually try to keep myself ready a little earlier than the appointment. So I was almost ready at about 6:45. So from my hotel room, I came down and looked down. The reception was cleanly visible. So I looked down and I saw 6:45, Mr. Pichai, the Japanese. He was already there in the reception, but I saw him coming in. He came, he saw the time, he looked at his watch, he saw the time, and then he went and sat in the reception area, and he picked up a newspaper or something, he was reading something, and he was noticing the time and reading, and I was observing him. Exactly at 7 o'clock, he got up, folded the paper, kept it, came, picked up the phone, and dialed my room. He said, Mr. Habib, I'm here. Wow. I noticed something very unique. He came at 6:45. He could have called me at 6:45. He didn't do that. He said, I'll pick you up at 7. He exactly got up and dialed me at 7 o'clock. He respected not his own time. He respected my time as well. Right? I was like, oh, wow, great. So we started moving. I started traveling with him. We had a lot of work to do. We traveled quite a bit. We went out of town. We went to factories. It was a granite project basically. So we went to factories. We went and saw what has to be done, and all the other discussions happened. And meanwhile, I asked him, Mr. Pichai, what is your age? And I've shared this story many a times, and it really inspires me every time I share this story. Mr. Pichai, what is your age? Pichai turned around and with there's a twinkling in his eye and there's a smile, and you know that childish naughty smile, and he looks at me and he with a twinkle in his eyes he says, which age? Maine socha yaar ye Japanese hai, isko samajh mein nahi aa raha. This fellow is not able to understand what I'm saying. So I said, no, Mr. Pichai, I'm asking you your age. So he turned around and said, which age? So then I said, Mr. Pichai, I don't understand what you're saying. Please explain to me. I don't understand. So Mr. Pichai turned around and said, Habib, I have two age. One, the physical age, biological age, 76. In 1998, he was 76. He said the physical age, biological age, 76, and I can't do anything about it. And I was waiting. Then he said, but my age inside here and here. What did he say? My age inside is 18, he said. I said, come on, Mr. Pichai, all this is theories. I really don't believe in all these things. ये सब थ्योरीज हैं, ये सब बोलने वाली बातें हैं. उम्र बाहर से अलग, अंदर से अलग. How can it be? So he said, I can prove it to you. I said, yeah, tell me. What is the proof? He said, you've been with me from past 24 hours. Don't you notice me working at very good pace? Don't you notice me happy? Don't you notice me vibrating? Don't you notice me enthusiastic? Don't you notice that I'm very full of life and energy? I said, yes. 18 years only, no. Agar I'm not 18 from inside, I cannot do all this. I've seen a lot of people, dear friends, I've seen a lot of people who are young biologically, but old emotionally, mentally. And I've seen a lot of people who are very old biologically, but very young from inside. Who are you? What are you? What's your choice you're doing? What's the choice you are making? So I asked Mr. Pichai, okay, I agree that you're 76 from outside and 18 from inside. I agree, because I see you, you're like this, you're living your life like this. So tell me what makes you like this, because I wanted to know what makes a human being like this. क्या चीज है जो एक इंसान को अंदर से एब्सोल्यूटली वाइब्रेंट बनाती है, एब्सोल्यूटली एंथुजियास्टिक बनाती है, एब्सोल्यूटली फुल ऑफ लाइफ. एंड आई रियली सॉ पिचाई वॉज नॉट सर्वाइविंग, ही वॉज लिविंग, ही वॉज लीडिंग अ फैंटास्टिक लाइफ. एंड एट 76 ही इज मैनेजिंग अ बिजनेस, एंड एट 76 ही इज स्टेइंग अवे फ्रॉम जापान, हिज मदरलैंड, एंड ही इज इन बैंकॉक managing multiple businesses, water treatment plant tha, he had got a heavy duty equipment company, then he had got this granite company, and he had got some contracting, a lot of things he was doing. He said, it's a secret, I'll tell you. So we went driving, and he took me to a very huge football stadium ke jaisa ek restaurant tha. He took me there and we started conversing, we had a lot of discussions, and as we were discussing, he said, Habib, your question, you said, what makes me feel young inside? I said, yeah, I'm really curious to know. His English was very broken. English utni achhi nahi thi. Lekin, whatever he said, the summary of all that was what I was able to gather. And it was really amazing. And I really tell you, one Japanese is equal to one university. And it really confirmed that fact. So when I was talking to him, he said, Habib, you know, I don't run behind goals. For me, it was like a shock. Are yaar, you left your country, you came here, you established this water treatment business, you established this heavy equipment company, a granite company, a construction company, and all these portfolios, and you say you don't run behind goals. Habib, you didn't listen. Listen. Develop listening, he said. I said, yeah, tell me, I'm listening. He said, no, you're hearing. You're just there. You're not listening. Listening is about absorbing the information and digesting that information. I said, oh, tell me. I said, I don't run behind goals. I said, yeah. Habib, I don't run behind goals. I said, yeah, it doesn't mean I don't have goals, he said. I have goals, but I don't run behind them. I said, okay, so what do you run behind? He said, I run behind a vision. What? First time I'm hearing this word in a very different perspective. Till then, I was hearing vision bole to, I used to hear about the spectacle store or the, you know, the glasses store where you go and check your vision, right? That's all I have been hearing about. Now he gives me that. This is way back in 1998. And he says, I run behind a vision. I said, what is, I mean, I don't understand. He said, anything you aspire, desire, you know, you're hungry for your own self is a goal. And it's usually connected to material. Anything you aspire, desire, and you're hungry for your own self is a goal. Anything you aspire, desire, and you're hungry for to make a difference to other people's lives is a vision. 20% of the world's population run behind a vision. That's why they are so light and lively. 80% of the world's population are running behind material goals. That's why they are tired. They are unresourceful. And they survive because they have to keep grappling with it. While I am telling you this, this is such a profound message. I hope you get it. While I am telling you this, I am grappling with it as well. Sometimes such, you know, goals, attractive goals pop up in front of us, and then we tend to run behind them. Then I said, Pichai, Mr. Pichai, then you're not running behind goals and you have goals. What does it mean? He said, when you have a vision, aapke paas ek vision hai. Vision ka matlab kya hai? Dusron ke liye kuch karne ki ek andar se tadap. That is a vision. Every single student, I wish our education system has a subject which tells about developing a vision. Default say a lot of people develop their own vision, but majority of the people don't even understand what a vision is. That's why they fall for a goal. That's why they fall for, you know, material. So I said, sir, can you give me differentiation? He said, a person who has a vision does not need to run behind goals. The goals will come to him. And a person who has goals has to keep running behind them, and they keep running away from them. I said, okay, this is some kind of a theory. He said, no, Habib, it is a law. It's like as profound as gravity. I said, what do you mean? He said, gravity mein agar aap mane ya na mane, gravity to chalti hai. Hai na? Even if you don't believe in the law of gravity, gravity is there. You jump off the building saying that I don't believe in gravity, but you will fall and you will die. Even if you don't believe in gravity, gravity is going to act on you because it is true. Exactly like that, there's a law of goals. If you have a vision, goals are going to run towards you because you're noble in your intentions. You're noble in your thoughts and you're trying to do it for others, right? So you'll have an array of goals running towards you and becoming a part of your life, right? And they could be material goals, but they are material goals which are means goals which are going to help you achieve your vision. Whereas people who are grappling with meager material goals, they're always running behind, always stressed, always surviving, survival mode, right? So this is one of the greatest lesson. Acha, what Mr. Pichai said in his broken English was all, you know, scattered. For me, it took time for me to absorb and assimilate within my own self. But then it was a greater realization for me that, you know, all the prophets, all the great people in this world, who have done something, if you notice their lives, they never worked for themselves. Take the example of Gandhiji. Was he wearing a very expensive suit? Did he drive a very expensive car? Did he stay in a very big, bungalow? Not at all. Simple life. Minimalistic life, they say, right? He was minimalistic. He was hardly clothed. But look at the dream or the vision he carried. He said, I want to get India independent. I want to get every Indian his freedom. Wow. Nelson Mandela lijiye. A Prophet Muhammad lijiye. Prophet Jesus lijiye. Anybody you pick up from anywhere, you will get the same example that they all lived for a vision. They never lived for means goals. They never lived for material goals. They were never had this aspiration of getting their branded suit or branded car. It is not bad to have them, but don't become a slave of them. Right? Because these people never became a slave of these things. It's good. You want to construct your house? Good. Want to buy a car? Good. But don't become a slave. Use it to achieve the vision. Use these things to achieve the vision. And vision can be something very noble. So I went digging deeper with Mr. Pichai because I wanted to know. Ye bol jo bol raha hai, iske andar dam hai, iske andar sachai hai, kuch hai, nahi hai. So I wanted to know, I was selfish about that, you know, that part of the learning. So I asked, Mr. Pichai, can you tell me what is your vision? There, now you come to the point. And he said, when I left Japan, I stayed in a village which did not have drinking water. So when I left Japan, I didn't have any money. I left with a vision saying that I want to provide drinking water to this village. That was my vision. And even today, that is what keeps me alive, keeps me going, and keeps me working for all these businesses, all these goals which you are seeing. I work very hard, very desperately, very, you know, unconditionally, because the income which comes, the profits which come from there are going towards providing drinking water. I said, wow, man, you made my day. You made my trip to Bangkok. Amazing. Just think about this story. Aap aur main. बचपन से हमें सिखाया क्या गया है, कामयाब बनो. यू नो, कामयाबी कैसे होती है? बाय हैविंग अ लॉट ऑफ मटेरियल. कामयाबी कैसे होती है? व्हाट आर द बेंचमार्क्स गिवन? व्हाट आर द बेंचमार्क्स? हैव अ गुड हाउस, गेट मैरिड टू अ गुड गर्ल और गेट मैरिड टू अ गुड बॉय एंड यू हैव चिल्ड्रन एंड यू हैव अ गुड हाउस, यू हैव अ गुड कार, यू हैव अ स्टेबल इनकम, देन यू आर सक्सेसफुल, राइट? दैट वॉज हाउ वी वर, यू नो, एक्सप्लेन सक्सेस. बट लुक एट दिस मैन. Pichai and people like him, what are the stories they are telling? Success is not about how many milestones you achieved materialistically. It is not success. That's not true success. It's about how much of impact you made towards others. What is the impact you made towards mankind? Wow. Think about it. When I was young, I remember bits and pieces, and it makes me emotional that when my mom used to come and feed me, I'm in a rush to go to the school and she's feeding me, my breakfast. She used to say, beta, jo bhi karo parwa nahi, logon ka achha karo. Jo bhi karo. Whatever you become, it's fine. Become whatever you become. But whatever you do, do good for others. With that note, I hope, I didn't want to expand and go into too much of detail in giving you too much of content. But today, a message from my heart for all of you, as much as it is for me. And it implies to me first that let us be human beings having a vision to make some difference to somebody. And you know that beautiful story which really changed my life. I have told this story so many times to people and I never get bored of it. I heard the story on one of the programs which I attended. I think it was a valedictory or something like that. And there was somebody very nice who came as a chief guest and he shared this story. And I believe this is the story of one of the books also. But beautiful story and really made a big difference in my life. There was an author writing a book. He was on the seashore and he saw a small kid, chota bachcha tha, and he was walking around picking up starfish and throwing it back into the ocean. And as he was doing this, this author went to the child, tapped him and said, son, there are thousands of beaches in this world. There are millions of starfish which are dying. What difference does your effort do? This kid picked up the starfish in his hand, did not say anything, picked up the starfish, threw it into the ocean and said it made a difference to that one. What size of work you and I do does not matter. What quality. And if we are able to make a difference to one life, we are done. Sincerely, if we are able to make a difference to one life, to our own family, to our own neighborhood, to the people we can impact, I think our job is done. So with that note of telling you and my own self, let us be human beings who live, not survive. And the only way to live with enthusiasm, with energy, with that beautiful feeling of being alive, the one and the most proven way is to have a vision in life, not just goals. Thank you so much. God bless you all.